transracial liberal accidentally destroys another one of the left's infamous arguments. Transgenders have had many reasons to celebrate recently as the left attempts to force society to embrace any and every lifestyle choice, regardless of science or religion. Of course, tolerance isn't enough as they demand to be not only accepted but celebrated. Sadly, as conservatives have warned, it won't stop with gender, and one transracial liberal is proving just that as he claims to be Filipino. However, he inadvertently destroyed one of the left's other infamous arguments, and liberals are about to start squirming when they realize what they've done. Liberals have decided to disregard any use for science in pushing their agenda, which ultimately seeks to destroy morality. Their ability to abandon biology has made them feel as if they have complete control over the world. Now, one self-proclaimed transsexual has changed the game, proving you can be absolutely anything after claiming to be not only transsexual but transracial too, and for a very odd reason. Leftists have officially changed the game entirely, foregoing science and making it 100% alright to be whatever you feel like being in the morning when you wake up. You're a female but wake up feeling like a male? That's fine, in the eyes of liberals, you're a man. Your anatomy completely goes out the window. Now that transgenders have made their mark, liberals needed a new project, and they have found it. Transracial. If you don't like being white, guess what? You can be black. In the world of the left, everyone will have to treat you like you're black. These people grow increasingly more mentally unstable by the minute and continue to one-up their last-minute blowing idea. Now, Yadu, who was born a white male named Adam, identifies as Filipino. However, little does the left realize, this flies in the face of one of their other talking points, white privilege. But, we'll get back to that. First, let's take a closer look at this recent insanity. According to ABC 10, riding in a flamboyant purple vehicle, Yadu arrived at a coffee shop to open up about his new identity. Yadu, born a white male named Adam, now considers himself a Filipino. The purple ride he drives around in is called a tuk-tuk, an Asian-derived vehicle used for public transit in the Philippines, he says. Yadu is part of a small, but growing community of people who consider themselves transracial, which refers to someone born one race but identifies with another. Yadu has decided to identify as a Filipino solely because he enjoys the food, culture, and watching the History Channel. Whenever I'm around the music, around the food, I feel like I'm in my own skin, Yadu explains, saying how he grew up enjoying Filipino food, events, and the overall culture, USA Today reports. I'd watch the History Channel, sometimes for hours. Nothing else intrigued me more but things about Filipino culture. If it's that easy, you could walk into a Mexican restaurant, love your enchiladas and walk out a Hispanic. However, we're not too sure what is more twisted, the fact that people are normalizing this or the individual who is pulling this scam. The ones who preach about climate change and science are the ones trying to add genders into the mix. This is now the world we are living in. We have the left to thank for this in more ways than one. After all the decrying of cultural appropriation, it's no wonder some of these individuals seem to think you can't appreciate a culture other than their own. What's worse, their own logic in one area completely erodes their argument in another. Besides, if being born a white male is such a privileged status, why in the world would anyone choose to be anything else? This is utter insanity at its finest. Feelings suddenly negate facts. Science and biology are ignored. It's time to say enough is enough. I'd say, what's next, but I'm afraid of the answer when logic is completely ignored because someone subjectively decides that they don't like the way the truth makes them feel.